हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सोमिया तिवारी फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन अरविंदो मेडिकल कॉलेज इंदौर। हियर इज माय नेक्स्ट वीडियो फ्रॉम पार्क, दैट इज डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट। फ्यू शॉर्ट नोट्स आर आस्क्ड फ्रॉम दिस क्वेश्चन एंड वेरी ऑफन अ लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन आल्सो इज आस्क्ड समटाइम्स फॉर द यूजी एग्जामिनेशन। सो हियर वी स्टार्ट द चैप्टर विदाउट एनी डिले। Disaster. So any occurrence that causes damage, ecological disruption, loss of human life or deterioration of health and health services on a scale which is sufficient to warrant an extraordinary response from outside the affected community or area. Okay? So it is the damage which causes ecological disruption, the loss of human life or deterioration of health and health services on such a scale that it disturbs the community. And hazard is what? Hazard is a phenomenon that has the potential to cause disruption or damage to the people and their environment. Now, what are the types of disaster? Now, according to your book, there are various kinds of disaster. Like we have seen in this diagram, it's not very neat and clean, but I have tried my best to write everything in it. Like we have famines, we have heat waves, we have tornadoes, earthquakes, cyclones, building collapse, floods, tidal waves, epidemics, landslides, volcanic eruptions, toxicological accidents and warfare, fires, hurricanes, snowstorms, etc. So these are the various types of disaster. Now, what are the morbidity which result from disaster? They are classified into certain types according to the book. So they are injuries, emotional stress can be there, epidemic of any disease can be there, an increase in the indigenous disease can be there. Like the pandemic of coronavirus is also a type of disaster which is affecting many kinds of life and affecting economically, affecting psychologically, socially, and of course with the life. Now coming to the next slide, the management sequence of a sudden onset of disaster. Now any kind of disaster which we have seen earlier, the types of disaster. So what is the management of different types of disaster? How we are going to if a disaster occurs suddenly? So this is the flowchart which is given in your book. First of all, disaster impact, right? First thing which we will do is the response, right? What response we will give in terms of helpness or in terms of quick action, what you are going to do, response when you come to know about certain types of disaster. Then rehabilitation, reconstruction, mitigation, and again the last point or the first point you can say, that is preparedness before the occurrence of any kind of disaster. So this is the flowchart which will be continued, that is the your disaster impact, your response, rehabilitation, reconstruction means what? Recovery phase after your disaster, mitigation and preparedness. And preparedness is, if it is done properly, then there will be the risk reduction phase before your disaster, like construction of building, or what are the pre and post precautions you are telling to the people before the disaster occurs. Now coming to the main part, that is disaster management. Okay, it is divided into various phases, and the three main steps which form the disaster cycle, as you can see here, are the disaster response, disaster preparedness and disaster mitigation. Now what occurs in disaster impact and response? That is your first step. So search, rescue and first aid is the most immediate help which comes from the uninjured survivors, right? So first step. Second will be your field care. So most injured persons converge to health facilities using whatever transport is available. then bed availability and surgical services should be maximized. Provision should be made for food and shelter, and centers should be established for responding to inquiries from the relatives of patient and friends, and priority should be given to the victims' identification. And the third point here is the triage. The short note is asked, and it is very important that what is triage, right? So it consists of rapidly classifying the injured on the basis of severity of their injuries and their likelihood of survival with prompt medical intervention. So high priority given to the victims with long-term prognosis, and lowest priority is given to the victims who have questionable benefits, right? And the color coding of the triage is divided into 4, not 3. In your exams, you are confused with IMNCI and you often write 3 categories. So please remember, in disaster, the triage consists of 4 colors, right? Red, yellow, green and black. Red means high priority treatment transfer, yellow means medium priority, green means ambulatory patients, and black means dead or moribund patients. Now, persons with minor or moderate injuries, they are treated at their homes to avoid social dislocation. And seriously injured are transported to the hospitals with specialized facilities. Then the next point comes the tagging. Tagging means what? All the patients are identified with tags stating their name, age, place of origin, the triage category and the diagnosis and initial treatment. Then identification of the dead. Now care of dead, what all things we will do. So first will be the removal of the dead from the disaster scene, shifting to the mortuary, identification, reception of bereaved relatives, and proper respect of the dead should be there at all points of view. So tagging. Then second step in your disaster cycle consists of the relief phase. So this phase begins with assistance from outside starts to reach the disaster area, right? So this phase, it will begin when the assistance from outside starts to reach the disaster area. Now help from outside is coming. Type and quantity of humanitarian relief supplies are determined by 2 main factors. First is the type of disaster, and second is the type and quantity of supplies which are available locally. Now following the initial emergency phase, needed supplies will include what? You will need food, clothing, blankets, shelter, sanitary engineering equipments, and your construction material. Now 4 principal components in managing the humanitarian supplies will include what? First will be your acquisition of the supplies. You should be acquainted with it. Then will be the transportation, storage, and distribution. Now coming to the next slide, which says about epidemiological surveillance and the disease control. Now disasters can increase the transmission of communicable disease through what all things, right? So it will overcrowding will be there and poor sanitation will be there, so it will increase the risk of ARI, acute respiratory tract infections. Then population displacement is there from here to there. It will lead to introduction of communicable diseases. Then disruption and contamination of water supply, damage to the sewage system and the power systems. Then disruption of routine control programs on funds and personnel are usually diverted to the relief work. And ecological changes may favor the breeding of vector and increase the vector population. And displacement of domestic and wild animals can lead to transmission of zoonosis. Then provision of emergency food, water and shelter in disaster situation may itself can be a new source of infection, that from where the food and everything is coming, right? So epidemiological surveillance and disease control, again I am repeating the points, overcrowding will be there, so ARI can occur. Then increase in the communicable disease can be there. Then your routine work will be disrupted, like this time also during the corona, everything is disturbed, the routine works are disturbed. Then ecological changes will occur that will lead to the breeding of vectors, zoonoses can occur, then from which place you are getting the food and water can itself be a new source of infection. Now coming to the next slide, which says about the vaccination, what all is important and not, we'll see it. Now, political pressure begin mass vaccination programs, usually against the typhoid, cholera and tetanus. WHO does not recommend typhoid and cholera in routine use in the endemic areas. Newer typhoid and cholera vaccine have increased efficacy, but because multi-dose vaccines have occurred, the compliance is poor. So best protection is maintenance of highest level of immunity in the general population by routine vaccination before the disaster occurs, and adequate wound healing and treatment. If tetanus immunization received more than 5 years in the patient with open wound, a TT booster is an effective preventive measure. And in previously one who is unimmunized injured patients, TT can be given only at discretion of a physician. So they are just discussing about the vaccines that in routine, the cholera and typhoid, they are not given by the WHO, right? But we can immunize the persons beforehand only, before the disaster occurs, with these vaccines also for the purpose of prevention, right? Then coming to the next point, that is nutrition. Nutrition plays a very important role. Now infants, children, pregnant women and your nursing mothers, sick persons, they are more prone to the nutritional problems. Now what are the steps for ensuring the food relief program? Okay, so first will be assessing the food supply after the disaster, from where it is coming, where it is going, assess. Second point will be what are your nutritional needs of the affected population, right? Third will be your daily food rations. You have to calculate it. Then your fourth point will be monitoring the nutritional status of the affected population, right? So nutrition, you have to see the food supply, assess it. Then you have to calculate the nutritional needs, calculate the daily food ration, and you have to monitor the nutritional status of the affected population, right? Coming to the next slide, that is shows about rehabilitation, right? So rehabilitation consists of several points which we are going to discuss simultaneously. First is the water supply. So chlorination of water should occur after the disaster has taken place, right? So increase residual level to 0.2 to 0.5 milligram per liter. Then low water pressure increases the risk of infiltration of pollutants into the water mains. Strict access to the people and animals if possible. Erect a fence and appoint a guard near the water source which you have created. Then ensure adequate excreta disposal at safe distance from the water source. Prohibit bathing, washing and animal husbandry upstream of intake points in rivers and streams. Then upgrade the wells to ensure that they are protected from contamination, and estimate the maximum yield of wells. Second point in rehabilitation we talk about is your food safety, right? So poor hygiene can be the major cause of foodborne diseases in the disaster situation. Then basic sanitation and personal hygiene to prevent fecal contamination of drinking water and food, right? Sanitary disposal of excreta should be done. Emergency latrines should be made available, and washing, cleaning and bathing facilities should also be provided. Then fourth point we are talking about is vector control. So dengue fever, malaria, leptospirosis, rat bite, fever, rats, typhus, then your plague, all these are prone to occur in the disaster phase, so you have to take care of them, right? So in rehabilitation, we have seen about the water supply, we have seen about the food safety, the basic hygiene and the basic sanitation and the personal hygiene and the vector control. Then the next point we are coming in disaster cycle is disaster mitigation, right? Disaster mitigation means what? Emergency prevention and mitigation involves measures designed either to prevent the hazards from causing emergency or to lessen the likely effects of emergencies. Now, what are the measures which occur in the mitigation? First of all, flood mitigation works are there. Then appropriate land use planning is there, improved building codes, reduction or protection of vulnerable population or structures. Mitigation means what? To reduce the vulnerability of the system. Now, medical casualties can be drastically reduced by improving the structured quality of houses, the schools and other public and private buildings. Now, the last point which we are going through the cycle was your disaster preparedness. You can say the last or the first point which you have to do before the occurrence of disaster, right? So, emergency preparedness is a program of long-term development activities whose goals are to strengthen the overall capacity and capability of a country to measure efficiently all the types of emergency. Now, what was the objective of preparedness, right? So, we can see in this slide, it's written that ensure appropriate systems, procedures and resources, they are in place to provide prompt effective assistance and disaster victims to disaster victims, thus facilitating relief measures and rehabilitation of services, right? So, the objective was you have to see that appropriate system is there, it is having appropriate procedure and it is also having appropriate resources, or everything is in place so that to the victims you can provide assistance to them. Now, what were the reasons for community preparedness? One or two times I have often seen the question asked as a short note on community preparedness. So, community preparedness is nothing but what it is. It's written in the red color. Three points you have to remember. First is that members of the community have most to lose from being vulnerable to the disaster and most to gain from an effective and appropriate emergency program. Those who first respond to the emergency come from the community, and next, the resources are most easily pooled at the community level. So, three things are there for preparedness, right? Beforehand, the disaster occurs, preparedness, you have to see that everything is in appropriate place, everything is functioning properly, you have all the resources properly, okay? So that you can assist or you can give assistance or help to those who need at the time of disaster. The community preparedness means what? See, whatever loss will be there, it will be to the community. Whatever gain will be there, it will be to the community. Whatever resources will be obtained, they will come from the community. And those who will first come at the time of disaster, in case of emergency, they will also be from the community. Now, coming to the next slide, which talks about the man-made disaster. Now, before shifting to this slide, I think once we should remember what all points we have seen till now, right? So, first of all, disaster management, if you talk about, just quickly briefing in 2 minutes. Disaster management consists of disaster response, preparedness and mitigation. Then, first point, humne dekha tha, disaster impact or response mein kya hota hai? 5 points hote hain. पहला होता है सर्च रेस्क्यू एंड फर्स्ट एड, दूसरा होता है फील्ड केयर, फिर होता है ट्रायज, फिर होता है टैगिंग और फिर होता है आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ द डेड. फिर हमने देखा था रिलीफ फेज. रिलीफ फेज में हमें कुछ नहीं देखना है, टाइप ऑफ डिजास्टर देखना है और कितनी क्या सप्लाई चाहिए हमें डिजास्टर के समय वो देखना है, ठीक है? तो हमें जो कंपोनेंट्स हैं, प्रिंसिपल कंपोनेंट्स क्या थे इसके, एक्विजिशन ऑफ सप्लाई, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, स्टोरेज एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. फिर हमने नेक्स्ट हेडिंग देखी थी एपिडेमियोलॉजिकल सर्वेलेंस एंड द डिजीज कंट्रोल, कि भैया जब डिजास्टर होगा तो क्या क्या चीजें होंगी. तो ओवरक्राउडिंग होगा तो ARI होगा, कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज फैलेंगे, जूनोसिस फैलेगा, फिर आपका डेली वर्क डिस्ट्रप्ट होगा और इकोलॉजिकल चेंजेस होंगे तो वेक्टर ब्रीडिंग होगी, जूनोसिस होगा. एंड जहां से भी खाना पानी आ रहा है दे इट कैन बी अ न्यू सोर्स ऑफ इन्फेक्शन. फिर हमने वैक्सीनेशन की बात की थी कि वैक्सीनेशन अगेंस्ट टाइफाइड, कॉलरा एंड टिटनेस, ये प्रिकॉशन के तौर पे हमें पहले से लगवा कर रखना चाहिए. फिर हमने न्यूट्रिशन की बात की थी, तो न्यूट्रिशन में हमने क्या क्या देखा था, एक तो असिस्ट करना है फूड सप्लाई को, फिर हमें डेली राशन को कैलकुलेट करना है, डेली फूड सप्लाई देखना है, और लास्ट में हमें मॉनिटरिंग करना है। फिर हमने देखा था रिहैबिलिटेशन, ठीक है, तो रिहैबिलिटेशन में हमने वाटर सप्लाई की बात की थी कि वहां पे क्लोरिनेशन होना चाहिए, प्रॉपर एक्सक्रीटा का डिस्पोजल होना चाहिए, पर्सनल हाइजीन होना चाहिए, एक फेंसिंग लगा होना चाहिए, ठीक है, और जो एक्सक्रीटा डिस्पोजल है या वेस्ट डिस्पोजल है उसको पानी के सोर्स से दूर होना चाहिए। तो पहली चीज वाटर सप्लाई हो गई। फूड सप्लाई में हमने बात की थी कि भैया जो है मतलब प्रॉपर हाइजीन मेंटेन करके चलना है। फिर बेसिक सैनिटेशन और पर्सनल हाइजीन मेजर्स हमें देखना है कि डिस्पोजल ऑफ एक्सक्रीटा हो रहा है कि नहीं, लैटरिंग्स बने हुए हैं कि नहीं, और जो वॉशिंग क्लीनिंग और बाथिंग फैसिलिटी है ये एक एरिया में प्रोवाइड की जा रही है कि नहीं की जा रही है। फिर लास्ट में हमें वेक्टर कंट्रोल पे भी ध्यान देना है। फिर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट था हमारा डिजास्टर मिटिगेशन इन हेल्थ सेक्टर। मिटिगेशन मतलब टू रिड्यूस द वल्नरेबिलिटी ऑफ द सिस्टम, ठीक है। तो मिटिगेशन सर्विसेज में हमें क्या होगा कि हमें स्ट्रक्चरल क्वालिटी ऑफ हाउस को अच्छा करना है, स्कूल, पब्लिक प्लेस, प्राइवेट बिल्डिंग, सबकी क्वालिटी को पहले से ही मजबूत और अच्छा करके रखना है, वो होता है मिटिगेशन। फिर होता है डिजास्टर प्रिपेयर्डनेस। प्रिपेयर्डनेस मतलब ये होता है कि हमें ओवरऑल कैपेसिटी ऑफ द सिस्टम को बढ़ाना है, हमें ये देखना है कि कहाँ पे कितने रिसोर्सेज हैं, किस प्रकार से बटे हुए हैं, ताकि हम इमरजेंसी के समय असिस्ट कर सकें या हेल्प कर सकें उन लोगों को जिनको इनकी ज़रूरत है। और कम्युनिटी प्रिपेयर्डनेस एक अलग से टर्म दिया है। ये क्यों दिया है, क्योंकि सबसे पहले जो इफेक्ट होता है डिजास्टर के समय वो कम्युनिटी इफेक्ट होती है। जो भी लॉस होता है वो कम्युनिटी को होता है, जो भी फायदा होता है वो कम्युनिटी को होता है। सबसे पहली हेल्प जो आती है वो कम्युनिटी से आती है, और रिसोर्सेज जो रहते हैं वो इजीली पूल हो जाते हैं एट द कम्युनिटी लेवल। नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, दैट इज मैन मेड डिजास्टर्स, ठीक है। मैन मेड डिजास्टर्स जो थे वो कुछ हमारी किताब में दिए हुए हैं, जैसे कि सडन डिजास्टर्स, भोपाल गैस ट्रेजेडी इन इंडिया ऑन 3rd December 1984, वर्ल्ड अटैक मतलब अटैक ऑन द वर्ल्ड ट्रेड सेंटर इन द न्यूयॉर्क। फिर MCGS डिजास्टर्स होते हैं, जैसे कि केमिकल एक्सपोजर, रेडिएशन एक्सेट्रा। फिर हमारे इंडिया में डिजास्टर्स की एक लिस्ट दी है जो कि अभी तक हुए हैं और जो मेंशन्ड है बुक्स में। पहला था नॉर्दर्न माउंटेन रीजन्स में स्नो स्टॉर्म, लैंडस्लाइड्स, अर्थक्वेक। फिर हुआ था ईस्टर्न कोस्टल एरिया में सीवियर फ्लड आई थी, आंध्र प्रदेश, वेस्ट बंगाल, उड़ीसा में, फिर बिहार, असम, यूपी, फ्लड्स ऑलमोस्ट एवरी ईयर। ओडिशा सुपर साइक्लोन ऑन 29th October 1999, गुजरात फेस्ड अर्थक्वेक, सुनामी अकर्ड इन December 2004, अर्थक्वेक अकर्ड फ्रिक्वेंटली इन द जम्मू कश्मीर। फिर 1984 में हुआ था भोपाल गैस ट्रेजेडी, और इसमें जो गैस थी वो थी मिथाइल आइसोसाइनेट गैस। ये PPG क्वेश्चन भी है। देन इंडियन मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट जो है, इट प्लेज अ मेजर रोल, इट हैज 5 सेंटर्स, कहाँ कहाँ है। IMD जो होता है इंडियन मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट, इसके सेंटर्स कहाँ कहाँ है, तो वो कोलकाता में है, भुवनेश्वर में है, विशाखापट्टनम, चेन्नई एंड मुंबई फॉर डिटेक्शन एंड ट्रेसिंग ऑफ साइक्लोन स्टॉर्म्स। नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, दैट इज पॉलिसी डेवलपमेंट। पॉलिसी डेवलपमेंट मीन्स वॉट, यू हैव टू स्टैब्लिश लॉन्ग टर्म गोल्स, you have to assign responsibilities for achieving the goals, then you have to establish recommended work practice, and you have to determine the criteria for decision making. goals banane padenge, fir goals banane ke liye responsibility deni padegi aapas mein, theek hai, fir work practice kaisa hoga, aur last mein decision making hona chahiye. now what are the personal protection in different types of emergency, क्या क्या पर्सनल प्रोटेक्शन हो सकता है। अलग अलग इमरजेंसी हमारी किताब में दी है, पर ये कॉमन बताया गया है, सो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू रीड फ्रॉम हियर। फर्स्ट इज, डू नॉट यूज द टेलीफोन एक्सेप्ट टू कॉल फॉर हेल्प, सो एज टू लीव द टेलीफोन लाइंस फ्री फॉर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फॉर रिस्पॉन्स। देन लिसन टू द मैसेजेस व्हिच आर गिवन इन द रेडियो, कैरी आउट ऑफिशियल इंस्ट्रक्शंस गिविंग आउट on radio by the loudspeaker, keep family emergency kit ready. In all different types of emergency, it is better to be prepared than to get hurt. To get information so as to get organized, then to act and to wait rather than act hastily. Now this is the last slide, and I hope this lecture was useful to you. And just I have a request from you that you can read from your book that what are the personal protection measures. जैसे कि हमने अभी discuss किए कुछ points, ठीक है, telephone use नहीं करना है, रेडियो सुनते रहना है, फिर एक्शन लेना है वाइजली, ठीक है, हैफजर्ड नहीं होना है, हड़बड़ी नहीं मचाना है, ठीक है. तो इन आवर बुक्स इट इज गिवन फॉर फ्लड, स्टॉर्म्स, हुरिकेन्स एंड टोरेंडोज, अर्थक्वेक्स और क्लाउड्स ऑफ टॉक्सिक फ्यूम्स. इनकी डिफरेंट इमरजेंसीज के डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मेजर दिए हैं कि बिफोर क्या करना है, ड्यूरिंग क्या करना है और आफ्टर क्या करना है. हर एक का दिया है, बिफोर, ड्यूरिंग और आफ्टर. तो आई थिंक यू कैन गो थ्रू इट. Rest, the disaster management part and the definition part and the steps and the how we manage any kind of disaster, I have tried to cover it in the disaster cycle. But this point which I have written here ki different types of disaster mein kya hoga before, during or after, this you can go through the book, right? I hope you like this video. Okay, have a nice day, stay at home, stay safe. Thank you.